Hi, this is Srinivas Lakhim. Today we are going to discuss Linux based commands continuation. As part of today's session, we are going to discuss how to copy files and directories from one location to another location and how to move files and directories from one location to another location. And next we will see how to remove files and how to remove directories. Okay? Let's start practically. Okay, see, currently I'm in /opt directory. How do we find the current working directory? So pwd stands for present working directory. Currently I'm in /opt directory. How can we see list of files and directories? ls space hyphen l. L stands for long list. Okay, so we have files and directories. So how can we find whether this is a file or directory by seeing this option? So these are called file permissions. In next session we will see what are file permissions. Okay, in this file permissions, this is called, first one is called file type. This one is called file type. This file type says whether this is a file or directory. When you see hyphen means it is a file. When you see d means it is a directory. Okay, so first two are files. Next one is directory. Okay, so we have list of files and directories. We have list of files and directories. Okay. So in this, I want to copy file from opt directory to my home directory or some different directory. We use cp and file name. I want to copy file one from opt directory to /root directory. Okay, file one, and I am copying this file into /root. If you not specify file file name, it copies same file name. Okay, ls space hyphen root. In root it is copied file one. Okay, if you want to copy multiple files with some extension, so we use cp space. See, I have multiple jar files. I have abc.jar, demo.jar, test.jar and xyz.jar. I want to copy all jar files at a time. Just use *.jar from current directory to /root. Let's execute ls command so that you will find all jar files are copied from our current directory to root directory, right? So if you have any extension, you can copy all that extension related files from our current directory to specified location with a single command. Okay, instead of copying one file at a time, you can copy bunch of files from our current location or some specified location to target location. Okay, see, this is copying files. Next, I want to copy cnotec directory from current directory to root directory, root home directory. So we use cp command, same command, synotec, and I want to copy this directory to under opt. Can you guess, is this directory copies from slash opt to, sorry, slash opt to root, right? Sure. Let's press enter and see the output. When you try to copy directory from one location to another location, it gives some information saying omitting directory synotec. It is not copying directory from one location to another location. Why it is not copying? Can you guess? See, directory is not a single file, single directory. It may contain some files, it may contain subdirectories, right? A directory may contain some files and some subdirectories. So when we want to copy that directory, we need to give some special indication to Linux kernel, a copy all including files and subdirectories presented in this directory. For that one, we use an option called -r. R stands for recursive. Recursively, it copies all contents presented from synotec to root directory. Press enter now, it will copy synotec directory. Okay, so ls slash root. See, synotec directory is now copied. So to copy directory, we have to give an additional option called -r, so that only Linux kernel understands and it copies from our specified directory to target location. Okay, next I want to move. See, if you use copy command, original file is presented, original file or directory presented in current specified location, and it maintain duplicate copy in destination, right? So it copies the same copy, it creates one more duplicate copy in specified location. So in source location, file is available, file or directory is available. In destination location, file or directory is copied. It means we have two copies. Instead of maintaining two copies, I want to move file or directory from specified location to destination location. I don't want maintain one more copy in my source location. I want to move. For that one, we use mv command. Mv stands for move. If you say mv a source file or directory, it moves that file or directory from specified location to destination location. Let's see, in current location we have these files, right? Some are the files. I want to move here from specified location to destination location. See, destination location is this root home directory. In root home directory, there is no Linux 11 file. So current location has Linux 11 file. I am moving this file from current location to root home directory. Then it simply remove this file from here and places this file into root home directory. Let's see here. MV Linux 11 under root. I am moving current location to destination location. Enter ls. There is no Linux 11 file. Ls slash root. You see Linux 11 here. You understand the difference, right? You understand the difference between CP and MV, right? Let's move directly from current location to destination location. I want to move DIR1 directory from current location to destination. In destination, there is no DIR1. Let's move MV. MV, DIR1. Sorry. And I want to move this one to root. Guess, is this command moves directory 1 to specify location? Sure? Yes? No? Why no? Yes, you are correct. Because this is a directory. If you want to move directory, we have to give some special indication to Linux. Let's try this option first. It is moved. So MV command not asking us, because directory 1 may not contain any files. I'm moving some other directory. So let's take first, let's see whether current working directory has DIR1 or not. No, it doesn't have. And let's see root home directory has directory 1 or not. Yes, it has. Let's move to one more directory, directory 3, cd directory 3, and here I'm creating some file cat abc, some data. Okay, control D, come out from this directory, clear. So ls, in current directory we have directory 3. Directory 3 has some files. Ls directory 3. So it has one file, right? I am trying to move this file from current working location to under root. Let's press enter. So it is moved directory 3 from current location to specified location. Okay? So it is not asking any confirmation. It's simply moving specified directory from specified location to target location. Okay? Next one, renaming file or directory. Renaming file or directory. Can you guess what is the command for rename? Rename command? Sure? Are you sure? Rename command? No. There is no rename command in Linux. There is no rename command in Linux. We use MV command for renaming purpose. What MV command do? It will move from source location to destination location. See, if I give source location is same, destination is location is same, but file name is different. Let's see, MV file 1, and I'm naming this as 3. Both I didn't specify specified destination location, means it saves 3 in same location, right? Let's see. Before that, let's see the content of file 1. Cat file 1. So file 1 has welcome Linux. Okay, so I am using MV file 1 and 3. LS, there is no file 1, it is renamed as 3. Let's display the content, cat 3. So you see same content, right? But file name is different. We renamed file 1 to 3. Okay, so to rename file or directory also we use MV command. Let's see, I want to rename directory 4 to some name, like I'm renaming directory 4 MV DIR4 to Srinu. Alas. So there is no directive for, it is renamed as Srinu. Okay? Next, very important command, very important command, remove, RM command. So RM stands for remove. By using RM command, we can remove file or we can remove directory. Let's first see removing files. Let's first see removing file. How to remove file? Okay? Yeah. I want to remove file abc or abc.jar file. You can remove any file. I am removing rm space, sorry, file name is abc.jar. See, it is asking us confirmation. If you are removing whether file or directory, it will ask you, it will prompt you, you want to remove file or not. If you want to remove, press Y, it will remove file. If you don't want to remove, press N, it will not remove. I don't want to remove. When I press, still file is available, abc.jar. See, here, when I use this command, it is asking me whether you want to remove file or not. So it is asking us confirmation. I don't want this confirmation message. I want to remove file without confirmation. For that one, we use an option called -f. -f stands for forcible. -f stands for forcible. It removes file or directory forcibly without asking any confirmation. Let's press enter. You will see the difference. Last time it has asked us confirmation, but this time it is not asked any confirmation. It simply removed specified file. Let's see how to remove directory. So to remove directory also we use same command, rm space directory name Srinu, Srinu Tech. It is giving us, yeah, maybe name is different, not Srinu Tech, Srinu Tech. Okay, so I am trying to remove directory. So it's simply saying cannot remove Srinu Tech. Srinu Tech is a directory. So if you want to remove any directory, it will say this is not a file, this is a directory. Why it is saying it is a directory? Directory is not a single write. It may has files, it may has subdirectories, right? If you remove directory, it will remove all content presented in it, right? So it is saying it is not a file, it is a directory. If you want to remove directory, we need to give an option called hyphen R. R stands for recursively. When I type this one here, see the difference here. Directory may contain multiple files, subdirectories, right? For each file and directory, it will ask us confirmation. If I say no, it will not remove. Because, just see, Srinu Tech has some other directory or some other files. Okay? So, I want to remove Srinu Tech without asking confirmation. So we use -f -rf. So we can combine multiple options. So rm space, r means recursively, f means forcibly. It removes Cenotech recursively, forcibly. It means it removes all the content presented in Cenotech. Let's press enter. It will not ask any confirmation. It is not saying it is a directory. Because of -r, it is not saying it is a directory. Because of F, it is not asking any confirmation. We will see in next class some more basic important commands. Okay? Thank you.